how to make a support shell using the duoMatrix NEO polymer-modified gypsum system. Today I'm going to show you how you can make a strong and durable support shell for your brush-on molds using the duoMatrix NEO. Now, today's video does have several goals. We're going to be showing you how to use the duoMatrix NEO with the Matrix chopped glass fibers to create a support shell that is a lower cost alternative to resins. We're going to be using the Matrix Thickener to build up fewer layers off the support shell, and we're going to be making it more impact resistant by using the Matrix chopped glass fibers. Finally, we will show you how to use the Matrix Accelerator to finish the support shell much quicker. So let's just jump into this project and see how it's done. For this project, we're using the duoMatrix NEO polymer modified gypsum system, which is a lower cost alternative to resins when compared on a per pound or per kilo basis. This is the thickener for the duoMatrix NEO. The thickener will help me apply the material to a vertical surface, and it will help me build up the thickness of 3/8 of an inch that I require for each side of the support shell in fewer layers. The technical bulletin will contain information on the dispensing ratio of the thickener based on weight, so we will need to use an accurate gram scale for the dispensing of the material here. Keep in mind that it's not recommended to go over 2.5 parts of the thickener by weight of the part B of the total mix. Also, really important to keep in mind is the fact that the usage of a thickener will prolong the working time and cure time of the duoMatrix NEO. Other important information to be found on the technical bulletin will be the mix ratio, which is 100 parts of A to 50 parts of B, and the working time, which is 30 minutes, while a cure time is 90 minutes. For this presentation, I will be using this platinum silicone brush-on mold. This is rebound 25. Now, while the duoMatrix NEO does stick to many surfaces and is adhesive, it will not stick to the silicone mold. However, the aluminum shims around here that are going to help us separate the two halves of the support shells do need some release agent. We're going to apply sonite wax to the aluminum shims as well as the working surface, which is a melamine board that does need a release agent on it. And you should read the duoMatrix NEO technical bulletin for release agent recommendations. The sonite wax is now allowed 20 to 30 minutes to dry. In the meantime, we can go ahead and dispense some of the duoMatrix NEO and the thickener. The part B of the duoMatrix NEO requires some pre-mixing before dispensing, so I'm going to shake the material container thoroughly in order to do so. We can now proceed to dispense the part A. Again, this is going to be 2 parts of the part A. And then we can dispense the part B, which is the liquid component, 1 part. Now the two components will get mixed together using a variable speed drill set on high with a mechanical mixer. And whenever you're adding dry and liquid components together, you always want to add the powder into the liquid and sift it in slowly while mixing the liquid component. This will eliminate any kind of lumping of the dry component in the liquid and produce a much better consistency of the product once it's mixed. By tilting the mixing container on the side, I'm able to concentrate the mass off material. Now I'm able to submerge the entire mechanical mixer and give the entire batch of material a good mixture. Now we're going to put the mixed component onto the scale, zero it out, and then add up to 2.5% of the thickener to the part B of the mix ratio. For example, the batch that I have mixed up here contains 200 grams of the part B, which is the liquid component. To get a thicker consistency, I added 2%, which is 4 grams of the thickener to the mixture once the A and B were combined. I'm going to repeat the mixing process for another 30 seconds. A quick check with a mixing stick shows me that the material consistency is now much thicker than the original mixed viscosity. The material can now be applied to our support shell buildup, and I'm going to start by brushing it on with a chip brush. I'll start at the bottom of the support shell and then work my way up towards the top. Do note that we're not applying the material over the keys that are along the bottom of the mold. This is by design. By keeping the backs of the keys open and material free, it's going to allow us to remove the keys out of the support shell and put them back in quickly and easily once the mold is in production. Keep in mind that the material itself will also continue to thicken over time as it continues to expire on the working time. It's important that you read and understand the technical bulletin and how the addition of some additives can either prolong the pot and cure time or shorten it. The first layer is now allowed a partial cure for 60 minutes. For the second layer, we are going to repeat the same dispensing and mixing procedure by adding some of the duoMatrix NEO thickener and then applying a second coat. By adding a second layer of the duoMatrix NEO with the thickener, we're further smoothing out the overall contours and lines of the support shell buildup here so that the next layer, which will be the reinforcement layer with chopped glass fibers, has a much easier time filling in the ridges in between the contours on this buildup, so that the previous layer and the thickened layer have a much easier time to bond and create less opportunity for air bubbles to be trapped between the two layers. The second layer is now allowed a partial cure for 60 minutes. The following layer will be the reinforced layer. We're going to reinforce the layer with some chopped matrix glass fibers. But more importantly, we're going to be adding an accelerator. The accelerator will help us to finish our entire project faster, but it also serves a secondary purpose where it actually thickens the material by expediting the cure and shortening the work time of a self-thickening product. The mix ratios for the accelerator can be found on the technical bulletin and should be followed to strictly control your work and demold time. The accelerator solution is mixed with 40 grams of the matrix accelerator to 480 grams of room temperature water. The mixing ratio for the chopped glass fibers can also be found in the technical bulletin under the hand layup technique using the chopped glass. We recommend a load ratio of 3 to 12% of the chopped glass fibers into the overall weight of the duoMatrix NEO that you mixed up for a specific batch. This is why it's important to use an accurate gram scale when dispensing additives to the duoMatrix NEO. The matrix chopped glass fibers enhance the performance and durability of your support shell or casting while providing primary reinforcement. They also provide a high tensile strength and are alkaline resistant and non-corrosive. The fibers are 3/4 inch in length or 19 millimeters. To use the duoMatrix NEO accelerator, we will have to mix it in a solution. So I'm going to dispense 480 grams of water at room temperature and then add 40 grams of the accelerator to that. This is why it's important to use an accurate gram scale when dispensing any kind of additives to the duoMatrix NEO in order to achieve the desired work time and cure time of the material. The powder is mixed in the water until it dissolves and the water turns clear again. The duoMatrix NEO accelerator solution is now ready to be used immediately
or can be stored away for future usage. If you do choose to store it away, make sure that you premix it prior to using it again. The duoMatrix NEO is dispensed 2 parts of A to 1 part of B. And then I'm also going to dispense the glass fibers right now by adding them at 6% of the total mixture. I'm going to dispense the accelerator at 5% of the weight of the part B that we will be using. This gives me a working time of 7 minutes and a cure time of 35 minutes. That's my personal preference. You guys can alter that based on the batches that you're using and the times that you're comfortable with. The dry components are added to the liquid by sifting the dry component into the liquid and mixing it using a variable speed drill set on high with a mechanical mixer. And the reason why we do this is to prevent any kind of lumping of the material. The accelerator is added while the duoMatrix NEO is mixed. I used a mix ratio of 5% of the accelerator to the part B of the duoMatrix NEO, which gave me a working time of 7 minutes and a cure of 35 minutes. And then add the glass fibers as well. You want to mix for another 30 seconds, not much longer, to make sure that you don't break down the glass fibers that were just added. It's important not to overmix the material once the glass fibers are added. You can actually destroy the glass fibers by overmixing and breaking them down. And then we can proceed to apply the material to the support shell buildup. As you can see here, the material holds a very good vertical surface, and I'm able to brush this up using a mixing stick. Make sure that you apply the reinforced layer with the glass fibers all the way to the edge of your support shell buildup. This will ensure that you have the same strength throughout the entire support shell. When glass fibers are encased in a casting medium such as the duoMatrix NEO, they cure into a much harder surface overall because of the stiffness that is given to the glass fibers by the encapsulating material. The material is now allowed a partial cure of 30 minutes. For the final layer, I'm going to add some thickener so I can further increase the thickness of the support shell that we're building up. Remember that we're aiming for 3/8 of an inch thickness of each side of the support shell. The final layer of the thickened duoMatrix NEO will also be the encapsulating layer for any glass fibers that are still sticking out from the reinforcement or third layer that we applied. So this layer will encapsulate some of those glass fibers even further and fill any air voids and gaps that have been left by the thickened previous layer. This is also the layer where we get to finally build up the thickness that we need for the overall support shell structure, which is about 3/8 of an inch. Remember, you can always add additional layers to increase the thickness if you find that your support shell is too thin. The first half of our support shell is now allowed a full cure for 90 minutes. After a full cure, the aluminum shims are removed, and we can proceed to make the second half of our support shell. At this point, I use a sharp razor knife to clean up the edges off the first half of the support shell. Some of those fibers will be sticking out and they're going to be sharp. I'm going to cut those and just overall just clean the edge a little bit. Also behind the keys where we indented those keys in the shims, you want to clean up that area as well to make sure it's nice and flat and doesn't cause any interlocking with the second half of the support shell. Now, some sonite wax is applied to the entire edge here of the support shell and is now allowed to dry for 20 to 30 minutes before proceeding on to the application of new material. The mixing procedure for the second half of our support shell is absolutely same, and we're going to be following the same procedures as far as mixing and applying the second side of the support shell layers. So the first two layers are going to be with the thickener, while the third and fourth layers, I ended up using the accelerator as an additive. Once the material is fully cured, I'm going to sand the edges using a 4.5-inch grinder. If you don't feel comfortable using tools like this, you can also use a sander. This just is a much faster way to abrade this material. And once we smooth out all the edges, I'm also going to touch up anywhere on the shell that I feel is sharp or there's glass fibers protruding. Once the support shell is clean enough and you don't have any sharp areas, we can then proceed to open up the mold by slowly driving a sharp object between the two halves to find the edge where they come together, and then proceeding to tap in some wood mixing sticks and to slowly pry those two halves open. Keep in mind that the first time you take the mold apart will be the hardest time, and you should go slow and wedge it slowly and wiggle it off of the opposite side. And here you have the support shell coming off. And again, the other side, again, go slowly. You don't want to break anything. This is still fairly fresh and it pops off quite easily. Now, I wanted to show you quickly also a strength test here with a rubber mallet. By adding the matrix chopped glass fibers, we were able to increase the strength and the impact resistance off the support shell overall. The duoMatrix NEO support shell and our silicone brush-on mold can now be put back together so we can cast into it. And as you can see, the silicone mold keys slip easily into the openings in the support shell, and the mold is now ready to be used. Now, if you got inspired by this project and you'd like to give your own projects a go and need some material, you can visit any one of our distributors around the world.
So, and there you have it, a step-by-step procedure that I use to create a strong and durable support shell using the duoMatrix NEO. Now, let's just take a quick look at our project goals. We were able to use the duoMatrix NEO and the matrix chopped glass fibers to create a support shell that is a lower cost alternative to resin. We used the matrix thickener to build up fewer layers for our support shell, and we made the support shell impact resistant by using the matrix chopped glass fibers. Finally, we used the matrix accelerator to finish the support shell much quicker. So there it is. Now, if you have an idea about what we should do next, please let us know down in the comments below. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button to keep up with our latest mold making, casting, and other videos. Remember to subscribe.